All right, let's tell the AI what it needs to do. So it needs to go to LinkedIn, publish a post about automation, and then search for two posts about automation and make a comment about them. Quite a general high-level instructions. And here we're gonna leave it the credentials if it needs them to access the account. So let's run this agent and let's see what happens. So the AI is opening the browser on my computer without any lines of code. So it has gone to LinkedIn. It figured out it has to go to LinkedIn. It's identifying all of the different elements on the page. It figured out it has to go to the login page. So I assume that it's going to use the credentials that I have given it to log in to LinkedIn. So yes, it's put the credentials correctly. So let's see if it's going to figure out how to log in. And it has done this without writing a single line of code. We're just instructing the AI what to do and what to do on our computer, on our browser, and it is trying to figure out and understand what to do. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to set this up on your computer. You don't need a fancy graphic card. You don't need a master's degree in computer science, anything like that. We are going to be using everything that is publicly available and free. And now we can see that the AI has actually created a post for us and has published a post for us. And now I guess it's searching for different posts on which to comment. So it is executing our automation without us writing a line of code. This is beginning to become more and more mainstream. Different technologies have this, or different platform providers like OpenAI has computer use, Anthropic has computer use, but this is a new technology and let's get into it and I will show you how to set it up for free on your computer. Let's get started. We are going to be using Browseruse. Now, the only requirement to use Browseruse is to have Python installed on your machine and also to have a tool that is going to allow you to read code. So a tool like Visual Studio. This is an open source platform, an open source tool that you can download just by searching for Visual Studio. Now, once you have downloaded and installed Visual Studio and you download and install Python version 3.11, you are ready to follow along. Now, what is Browseruse? Browseruse is a browser that allows AI to take control over the browser and click in different parts of the browser. It also understands better the different elements that are on the page, making it easier for the AI to click through the different parts of the browser and complete different tasks. Now, this technology, as I was saying previously, has been used also by Anthropic, computer use, also the operator from ChatGPT, which is a $200 monthly license, also uses this kind of technology. However, Browseruse from their chart obviously shows that it is providing really high success rate on completing these tasks. Now, this is an open source platform that you can use by downloading and installing it, but you can also use the cloud version. We are going to be downloading it and installing it on our computer. So to download and install it on our computer, we're going to go to the GitHub repo that is called Browseruse. However, we don't want to use the Browseruse via code. We want a Web GUI interface for the Browseruse, just like the one that I'm showing you right here. Why? Because it's going to make it much more easier for anybody to use this technology and run it immediately. So once we are on the GitHub page on Browseruse, we are going to scroll down and we're going to see obviously how to install it and set it up. Now, if you have set up Visual Studio and Python version 3.11 or greater, you can just run these commands and I will show you how, and you can set it up on the code. However, we want a UI interface for this. So to use the UI interface, we are going to go to the web UI from Browseruse and we're going to follow this guide to set this up for us. So this is leveraging all of, or the majority of, the functions that are available on the code. It's just that a GUI interface has been built for them so that you can write commands, you can set up different things, you can even use deep research, which is an amazing tool, and also you can run your agents and execute different tasks. Now, to set this up, let's start with installing Python 3.11 or higher. And we can also use Git for cloning the repo, but it is not necessary. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to open a new folder and we're going to create a new folder in our development dev folder. I'm going to call this browser use version 2. So after that, we're going to select this folder that we have just created, and a new empty folder is going to be created for us. We are going to run the terminal, so we can either copy this command right here and run it inside of the terminal, or we can go up here and we can download this code. So we can just download the zip code, put it in a folder and unzip it. But if you want things to move a little bit faster, you will just execute this command right here inside of your terminal. Now this is going to clone this repo. As you can see, now we have the entire repo. And after that, what we are going to do is just go inside of this repo with this command. So we see that we have changed the folder. Now we are in this repo. And if we type in ls, we can see all of the different contents that is inside of this repo. Now, the next thing that we have to do is we have to set up a Python virtual environment. Now, you can use this or you can use any other command that is that you can use on your machine to set up the Python virtual environment. On my machine, I have set it up to work like this. So if I type in Python mvanv, this is going to create a virtual environment folder that is going to be called vanv right here. Now, why are we creating a virtual environment? Because we're going to be installing different libraries that are going to be required to run this solution, and we don't want to install it on our local machine. So we're going to be installing it inside of this virtual environment. So that is pretty much everything, all of the installation that we have to do. So we have to activate our virtual environment after that. So once it has been created, we're just going to paste this command right here, and we see that our virtual environment has been activated. After that, we are ready to install the requirements. These are the requirements that are required to run this. So to install these requirements, it is going to take a little bit of time. All we have to do is run this command right here and install the requirements. This is going to install everything that we need. So we can see that right here we have Browseruse, Gradio, JSON Reaper, and different other libraries for Python that are available. So this is going to take a little bit of time. I'm going to exit out of this folder and go back into the one that I have already set up. For my system also, I needed to add this as well. So I wanted to show you this. I need to add this because I was getting an error when starting this. So just like previously, we're going to activate the virtual environment in this folder as well. And after that, what we need to do is, after we have installed everything, we're going to install also Playwright. This is going to give us the ability to use the browser. And after that, we are finally ready. We can install it also using Docker, but we're going to skip this step. And after that, we can just copy this command right here and we can paste it. And we can copy this command from right here and paste it inside of the terminal. Now, this is going to run the server on our local machine and give us the ability to execute the different agents via web UI using Browseruse. So this is going to run a local, browser, and we can use this browser however we want. It is not going to be connected to our cache, to our passwords. However, we can make it so that via code, so that it connects directly to our browser, so that we don't have to log in to anything. Now let's see how this works. So one thing that we need to do first is we need to set the API key. So I'm going to set the API key right here. And we can also change all of from the different models. We can select whichever model that we want to use. In this example, I'm going to be using GPT 4.0, which is the default model. We can also fine tune other agents things, such as the maximum number of steps. So if we want to, if we want it to go for a long time, we can increase this number. Also the maximum actions that it can take per step before going into an error. So after that, we can also configure the browser settings. In this example, I'm going to disable recording because it's just going to be taking up some space. And then we can run our agent. Now we can ask our agent whatever we want. I have created a fake account, which I will be changing the password, and a request that I've showed you previously. We're going to change this request. We're going to ask it to create a new post about how to create agents that post on LinkedIn. So also the more detailed we give here in the description of the task, the better the agent is going to perform. But let's just test it out and see if it is working. So let's run our agent. We gave it the credentials to log in. So we see it again opening the browser. It's going to LinkedIn. And here also, if you wanted to make it save a little bit of steps, we would tell it to go directly to the LinkedIn page, so that it skips this navigation part that it's doing. So it's first going to LinkedIn, it's figuring out that it has to sign in, and then it goes to the sign-in page. While this is running, we can also go back to where we have installed, our agent, and we can see exactly what is going on with the agent, what it is doing. So it has tried a couple of times clicking on different things, it has failed, it has given itself a new goal, it has taken three steps, it seems like it has made some progress. Let's go see what is happening right now. So we are back in the login page, and now it's creating again a post. This time it should create a post about how easy it is to create agents and automations. Obviously, these technologies are in its infancies. This is just the beginning of this, but I wanted to show you what is coming our way. What does all of this mean? All of this means to me, it means that any work that we do in front of the computer, it is very easily going to be automated by an AI agent to who we are going to just express the different tasks that need to be completed, or these tasks are going to be already digitalized, or somebody is going to tell the AI agents what to do and they are going to be completing all of these tasks. Now, where does this leave us? It leaves us that we have to upskill as soon as possible to learn how to use these technologies. So if you have stayed with me for so long, subscribe to the channel. I hope that you have liked this kind of video and that you're interested in more things like this. I am super curious about what kind of automations you want to see, and I constantly create automations that you guys want to see. So leave your comments down below, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.